of code is great, but sometimes it's really important to learn how to use your coding tools. Here are 5 tips and tricks that'll make your Ren'py experience go a lot smoother. And heck, stick around to the end of the video and I'll throw an extra tip in there for free. Tip number 1, master the Ren'py developer tools. When you launch your game for the Ren'py editor, you can press D to open the interactive editor that lets you modify or add lines of code that are being used on the current screen that you're on. If you decide, hey, I actually want to use a different expression for the character here, you can modify it directly through the interactive editor, and those changes will be reflected directly in your code. You can also add new lines with some limited functionality. You can add scenes, a show tag, hide tag, or add transitions with the with statement here, as well as add some basic sound stuff. And that's literally just the tip of the iceberg. Press Shift plus D to see a full list of developer tools. Interactive Director is probably the second most useful of the tools, but you'll probably find a reason to use everything here. The most useful is Reload Game with a hotkey of Shift plus R, which you'll use a lot. If you ever make changes to your code from your editor and want to see it reflected immediately, save your changes in the editor and press Shift R to reload your game to where you left off. Console is useful for running lines of code that you don't want to save to your editor. Stuff like testing out different characters in a screen, jumping to a label, or evaluating Python statements. Like here, I can change this randomized variable to one that I've selected. Back in the developer tools, Variable Viewer shows you the current values of a number of variables, which come in handy when you're debugging issues. Don't worry about image location picker, file name list, and image attributes. These just display the images, your files, and what images are currently on the screen, so not that useful, but image load log can be very interesting in certain contexts. Ren'py predicts which images will be shown to the user and loads a certain number of them in the cache that is certain the reader will get to. The image load log shows you that information, showing you the size of the images it's currently scanning, the cache that's already loaded, and how certain it is that it's going to know which images are going to come next. For most devs, this isn't that useful, but if you're making a very image-heavy game, like I tend to make, it could be very important to streamline it for low-end devices. The next tip, though, is something we could all be using a little bit more. Tip number 2. To-do comments. You really shouldn't be using random sheets of paper like I do to arrange your to-do list. You can do it right in Ren'py. You can comment in your code, hashtag, to-do, all one word, colon, and then add whatever text you want to save as a note. And Ren'py saves these comments internally in a different way than regular commented code. In your Ren'py launcher, go to the Actions section of your game and click Navigate Script. Under the category To-Dos, you'll see the to-do list for every .rpy file in your game. Ren'py comes with a lot of dev tools like this, but some of them pretty much anyone can use, player or dev. Tip number 3, Ren'py keyboard shortcuts. It's easy to remember some of the more commonly used Ren'py keyboard shortcuts, like spacebar advances the game, and you can use the arrow keys to go up and down menu options. But some lesser known keyboard shortcuts are still very useful. Like, let's say you wanted to get a nice screenshot of someone's Ren'py game. You can press the tab button, which skips through dialogue until it hits certain sections of the game that require player input. This will get to the important part of your visual novel quicker. Then you can press H to remove the text window interface and any other screens that cover the main staging area. Then press S to save a screenshot. And there are lots of other Ren'py keyboard shortcuts too. V uses your operating system's automatic voice thingy to just read your visual novel to you.
But that doesn't mean it will sound great, lol. Pay voice actors.
But not all of these Ren'py tips directly involve Ren'py. Tip number 4, learn text editor tricks. Ren'py supports a few different text editors, and with an extension that I'll link to below, you can even get rich support for Ren'py in Visual Studio Code. But for now, the most commonly used text editor for Ren'py is Atom Editor, and it's worth learning a few shortcuts. If you don't already know, Control F is a shortcut used for most web browsers and text editors to bring up the Find a Word menu. You'll usually find this if you want to find and replace a label, variable, or character name. I usually use this when I have to change every instance of a label being called in an RPY file. You can also use the shortcut Control plus P to check if a term is being used in any of your RPY files in that folder. For any label, menu, or screen, you can press this caret to the left of the code to collapse it down. I use this to organize my code simply along one file. I'll divide really complicated code into sections and give them descriptive labels so I can visually follow how the code is flowing from chunk of code to chunk of code. And I just learned this, but you can apparently just wrap your text in the atom editor, which comes in real handy when you have really long lines of code. In the atom editor, go to File and Settings. Under the Editor tab, you'll want to scroll down to the Soft Wrap setting and check it. With a long line of code or text, it will wrap around with a little dot right there to signify that it's a continuation of the previous line. And finally, use Control plus S to save. Do this a lot. Please save often. Tip number 5. Join the Ren'py Discord and subreddit. Listen, I love getting questions in the comments, don't get me wrong. And I try to answer them as best as I can. But when I want a question answered, I go right to the Ren'py subreddit or post a question in the Ren'py Discord. Both of them are really active and there are so many users there that are more than happy to help you sort out whatever issue you may have. Try to post all the relevant code you can when you have a question and be very specific about how the code is operating differently than you intend. Describe what it's currently doing, show screenshots, it's the S key to do that in Ren'py, and describe how you'd want the code to operate differently. If you get an exception has occurred, include the traceback and error code that Ren'py gives you. So you'll often have to answer like a lot of clarifying questions, but I don't think I've ever walked away from the Discord or the subreddit without a really solid game plan on how to fix my code. But on a very rare occasion, it's better to go to the source. And for that, I'll go to my bonus tip. Free tip number 6, sort of. It's not free, you donate to Ren'py development. Sometimes the best way to make your Ren'py games better is to make Ren'py better. Ren'py is a free engine, but it still takes time and money to update, maintain, and fix it. As Ren'py Tom says on his Patreon, up until this point, I've shouldered the cost of development software and equipment myself. However, keeping up with changing technology and standards can get pricey. Rather than work longer hours to fund development-related expenses, I've created this Patreon. Now you can help free up my time so that I can put more work into Ren'py and get some nice rewards in the process. Donating to Ren'py Tom's Patreon, which I have a link to in the doobly-doo, not only helps fund development, but gives you some nice little freebies. At $1, you get access to exclusive developer updates that not only give you really interesting insights into Ren'py's development, but sometimes have useful bits of code you can use in your own games. At $2, you'll get your name in the documentation forever. And at $10, you'll get a collectible Ren'py postcard and a text link on the Ren'py website. So give Ren'py Tom's Patreon a look, like it's worth it. Just go check it out, go check it out. And with that is 5 tips plus a little extra one. But if you want a deep dive on how Ren'py works, go ahead and check out the next video here, and happy coding.